Before we get into it, we're going to take a moment to acknowledge Wage War for their song, Manic, this week's song for Time to Football. Check it out anywhere you stream your music. A great matchup to kick off week 3 between the undefeated Miami Dolphins and the Cincinnati Bengals. The Dolphins proved that they're for real with their 21-19 victory against the Bills. The Bengals are hoping to get things going after a much-needed win against the Jets, as they could be in danger of falling to 1-3 if they lose this week. We're taking the Bengals in this one to win by 4. As ugly as the Bengals have looked, they more than likely are wanting to feature Ja'Marr Chase more, and when that happens, they look like the Bengals of the past. The spread to take here is the Bengals minus 3.5. Sorry West Coast fans are having to get up at 6:30 a.m. because the Minnesota Vikings face the New Orleans Saints in London. The last two offensive showings for the Saints have been stale, and it could continue to be worse if Michael Thomas or Jarvis Landry miss this week. The Vikings really want to feature Justin Jefferson, but he'll have yet another tough matchup against Marshawn Lattimore. Taking a look at the spread, we're going to go with Minnesota in this one by 7. Though the Vikings secondary isn't great, the Saints offense has too many injuries at this point. Our suggestion on the spread is Vikings minus 2.5. Transitioning into Sunday afternoon, the Cleveland Browns take on the Atlanta Falcons. Both teams have had all their games determined by one possession, so expect another close one. Atlanta picked up their first win last week, and the Browns continue to make noise with Jacoby Brissett. It's a close call, but we're rolling with the Browns in this one to win by 3. There's a lot more consistency on both sides of the ball with Cleveland. The spread to take here is Browns minus 1.5. Arguably the game of the week, the Buffalo Bills versus the Baltimore Ravens. The Ravens offense versus the Bills defense is the matchup to watch. Can Lamar Jackson continue his MVP-type season and extend the Ravens to a 3-1 record? However, can the Bills rebound following the upset loss last week? To answer that last question, we believe so. We're taking the Bills to win by 6. The Ravens secondary will have trouble against Stephon Diggs and Gabriel Davis. Our suggestion on the spread is to go with the Bills. NFC East battle between the Washington Commanders and the Dallas Cowboys. Washington's defense has put the Commanders in rough spots this year, and Carson Wentz and the offense has struggled to come back when in a deficit. But speaking of someone who has taken command, Cooper Rush remains undefeated as a starter in the NFL, leading the Cowboys to 2 straight wins. Our pick is going to be the Cowboys by 2. I expect this to be low scoring as the Commanders' offense could struggle big time for a second straight week against a stout defense. Since we expect this to be close, the spread I would take here is Commanders plus 3. Expect a lot of yards to be put up in this one. The Seattle Seahawks versus the Detroit Lions. It took a couple of weeks, but DK Metcalf and Tyler Lockett's roles in the offense are back to normal. The Lions took a big hit this week, as DeAndre Swift is out for a few weeks and Amon-Ra St. Brown might miss this game. Despite the injuries, we're still taking the Lions to win by 5. It's a great matchup for the Seahawks offense, but it's hard to envision them keeping up with the Lions. Our suggestion for the spread is Lions minus 4.5. The Los Angeles Chargers versus the Houston Texans. Not the start the Chargers expected, after Justin Herbert battled through broken cartilage in his ribs last week. The Texans are looking to pick up their first win this year after losing or tying each game by one possession. This is the week we expect the Chargers to get back on track. Chargers by 10. We still believe the Chargers are a playoff team, but they'd be in massive trouble if they lose this one. Chargers minus 5.5 is a pretty safe spread this week. The Tennessee Titans versus the Indianapolis Colts. Going into the season, one of these teams were favored to win the AFC South, but things haven't quite turned out that way. But they're both on the right track, with the Colts stunning the Chiefs and the Titans holding off the Raiders. We're going with the underdog in this one, the Tennessee Titans, to win by a field goal. The Colts' offense has done little to nothing this season, while Tennessee at least has shown that they can move downfield. Since the spread is Titans plus 3 and we have the Titans winning by 3, it may not be worth picking this one, but it's your discretion. The 2-1 Chicago Bears versus the 2-1 New York Giants. Didn't think anyone expected those records, but it's been all defense so far for both these teams. Expect another low-scoring defensive-heavy game. Wouldn't be surprising if any offense doesn't get over 20 points with the way that these teams have played. We're taking the Giants to win in this one by 2. The deciding factor is Saquon Barkley, who's playing at an elite level. It's too wide of a point spread, so I'm going with the Bears, plus 3.5. Both of these teams are off to a hot start, the Jacksonville Jaguars versus the Philadelphia Eagles. Jacksonville has surprised many of us the last couple of weeks, but they have their hands full against arguably a top 5 defense in Philadelphia. Jalen Hurts continues to impress, but don't discredit the Jaguars defense, who could cause some trouble for Hurts. The magic for the Jaguars might have to be put on a pause for this week, as we're taking the Eagles to win by 10. It's not because we don't think the Jaguars are good, but the Eagles might just be the best team in the NFC. The spread to take here is Eagles minus 6.5. Zach Wilson is expected to start for the New York Jets for their matchup against the Pittsburgh Steelers. Joe Flacco has been a solid step in, but now we'll see if Wilson can break through in his second season. The Steelers are off to a disappointing start, but the offense should look serviceable against a porous Jets defense. We're taking the Steelers in this one to win by 4, but I could see the Jets pulling off an upset as well, because Zach Wilson is the biggest unknown in this game. But I'm playing it safe, and I'm going with the Steelers minus 3. Will the Arizona Cardinals be playing from behind for a fourth straight week as they travel to Charlotte and face the Carolina Panthers? Arizona hasn't had a lead going into halftime in any game this year. Meanwhile, the Panthers fans are asking for a change, as Matt Rhule needs to get Baker Mayfield and the offense clicking before changes are made. We're picking the Cardinals to win by 9. Defensively, the Panthers are great, but their offense has held them back significantly. Surprisingly, the Cards are the underdog, so Cardinals plus 1.5 pretty much is a lock-in. The New England Patriots versus the Green Bay Packers. By the time this video was made, Bill Belichick is being secretive on Mac Jones' injury status, ruling him as day-to-day. Brian Hoyer, however, more than likely will be starting. Despite the inefficient Packers offense, they're 2-1 and might have found a hidden gem in Romeo Doubs. Somehow, Green Bay always gets it done with not much depth, so I'm picking the Packers to win by 6. The point spread is an overwhelming 9.5, but it might be closer than we think. To be on the safe side, Patriots plus 9.5 is the best option. Two teams that are in massive trouble, the Denver Broncos versus the Las Vegas Raiders. Despite the 2-1 record, the Broncos haven't looked like a winning team. While the Raiders are an offensive-heavy squad, they get burnt by their defense often. This is going to be close, but I'm going with the Broncos this week by 4. After 3 weeks to get adjusted, more than likely this is the week the offense finally plays like their true selves. The Raiders' defense is too exploitable. We're taking Broncos plus 2.5. Sunday Night Football, the Kansas City Chiefs versus the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. The Chiefs are looking to rebound after their upset loss to the Colts, while the Bucs need to get something going offensively. I hate to doubt Tom Brady, but his lack of weapons has hurt him. Though Mike Evans returns this week, we're still taking the Chiefs to win by 5. The spread pick here would be Chiefs minus 1.5. And finally, Monday Night Football, the Los Angeles Rams versus the San Francisco 49ers. Jimmy Garoppolo's return as a starter could have gone a bit differently, losing to the Broncos by 1 point. The Rams held off the Cardinals last week, despite the not-so-great showing on offense. This week, we're taking the 49ers at home by 2. The Rams tend to struggle against the 49ers, losing 2 of the 3 matchups last season. The point spread we're taking is 49ers minus 1.5. Before you guys go, be sure to hit that subscribe button and give me a follow on Twitter at @itshasankhan. We'd love to chat with everyone during the games. Thank you guys so much for watching this video.